إن الله يحب التوابين ويحب المتطهرين. طيب. Now listen to this. Allah loves those who often repent to Him, and He loves those who continuously purify themselves. What does it mean when you often repent? What does that suggest? That you don't sin? Would you repent if you didn't sin? Answer me. Would you repent if you didn't sin? No. You don't have a sin to repent from. Listen to what I'm saying. No one is free from sin. Don't you think that you don't sin? In case the shaitan has been tricking you to believe in that you don't sin, you're mistaken, my friend. No, you sin. And because of these sins, you have to seek repentance. If you didn't sin, you wouldn't seek repentance. If you didn't sin, you didn't make mistakes, you didn't err. But we do. So when Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ, that means you have to look at the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, كُلُّ ابْنِ آدَمْ خَطَّأْ وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. Every son of Adam is prone to sin, has a tendency to sin, is a sinner, but not born sinful. And the best of those who do so, who fall into sin, are those who repent. So each one of us has a share of attaining these sins or losing by sinning and disobeying Allah. And when you repent to Allah, Allah loves you. Ya subhanallah. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't it beautiful that when you do something wrong and then you apologize, that you will act, you know, human. Let's look at it in human communication. Okay, human relations. If you had a friend and then he did something which is not right, he wronged you, he oppressed you. When you apologize to him, what usually happens? Yeah, if he's really nice and he really likes you, he will let it slide. But he will still have something in his heart. Still some anger, some grudge, which he will not get rid of. Very often or very hardly, you will see someone who will wind up loving you more after you apologize. Wherein they forget about the whole thing. It doesn't happen. But with Allah Azza wa Jal, it's the other way around. You do something wrong, but you admit this wrong, and you beg Allah to forgive you, then Allah will love you for that. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillah. Because if that wasn't the case, we would be in trouble, my brothers and sisters in Islam. Wallahi, we'd be in big trouble. If every time we sinned, even if we repented, Allah did not love us, or Allah hated us, by the time we die, we will have zero love. We wouldn't have any left. Because we will continue to attain Allah's hatred and displeasure until we die. But it works the other way around. You fall into sin, you repent to Allah, Allah will love you. Needless to say, the ulama say, if you don't sin to begin with, it is better. That is not encouraging anyone to sin and then do repentance, because the shaitan will try to trick some people. Say, oh yeah? Tab yalla, let me go do A, B, C, D, F, G, and then I'll say, no, Habibi, no. If you have to leave things alone first, if you're unable and you wind up falling into sin, then this is when the tawbah is going to benefit you. This is the tawbah of the what? The cleansing of the what? The heart. وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. And Allah loves those who physically purify themselves. Sheikh bin Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala wa askanahu fasiha jannatih said something amazing which we hardly ever reflect on. He said, if you as a slave of Allah realized that every time you make wudu, you're attaining Allah's love, you would have felt very much different about the wudu which you perform. But truthfully speaking, when was the last time you felt when you're saying Bismillah and you're washing your hands, you're actually attaining Allah's love? Hardly ever. We're thinking this is a condition for Salah. And I need to make wudu so my salah can be valid. But we don't really reflect on the fact that this wudu is actually going to bring about Allah's love. Why? Absent-minded. Heedless. إلا من رحم الله. But the good news is, every time you make wudu, every time you make ghusl, every time you use the bathroom and you clean yourself afterwards, you're attaining Allah's love. This is something which you have to do anyways, but if you do it for the sake of Allah, then you will attain Allah's love. So now you have, every time you purify yourself inwardly, Allah will love you. Every time you purify yourself outwardly, Allah will love you. So, the love of Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِرِينَ. From now on, every time one of us sins and he repents to Allah, remember that you are acquiring Allah's love when you repent to Him. Notice the term tawwab. There's ta'ib. Ta'ib is a repentive person or a repenter, someone who repents once maybe. Tawwab is called sighatul mubalagha, hyperbole, meaning it is exaggerated. Someone who always and often repents. Like kathab and kathib. Kathab is a big liar. Not just a liar. Kathib is a liar. He may lie once a month. Kathab, he lies, a compulsive liar. Tawwab, someone who's always repenting to Allah. Which indicates that they don't insist on the sin. You see, in Surah Al-Imran, Allah says, when he said, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Pay attention now. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَن يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. This is the point here. Now Allah is describing the muttaqeen, those who will be promised Jannah, those who are promised Jannah, as wide as the heavens and the earth. What are their qualities? They spend the time of adversity and prosperity, and they suppress their anger, and they pardon the people, and Allah loves the muhsineen. And those who when they commit an abhorrent sin, fahisha ikhwan is like zina. Fahisha is that at the level of the gravity of the sin is zina and its likes. The muttaqeen may fall into that. Or they wrong themselves in other sins. But what is the quality of the muttaqeen? He doesn't remain absent-minded. Dhakarullah, they remember Allah. They remember Allah. Fastaghfaru, because of that they sought forgiveness for their sins. But it doesn't end. Who forgives the sins but Allah? No one. وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. But they do not persist on the sin while they know. So you can qualify to be a taqi even if you fall into a major sin, provided that you have these qualities. When you fall into the sin, you're not happy. You go to events, hey, I went out with her. You know, I finally got her. I did this, I got drunk, I got high, I got whatever. No. That's not the one who Allah will give these privileges. You may fall into these things, but when you do, you remember Allah. What have I done? What have I done? And you feel guilty, and you say, you beg Allah for forgiveness, and you don't continue to do this while you know. You may fall back into the sin afterwards, after repentance, but at that time you don't. Allah loves the muttaqeen. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ, which is the second ayah. So the muttaqeen, those who observe Allah's rights by doing what He commanded, avoiding what He forbade, may fall into these major sins. This is mercy from Allah. If the muttaqeen never fell into these sins, perhaps all of us will be disqualified. وَتِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي نُورِثُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا مَنْ كَانَ تَقِيًّا. That garden, that Jannah, we shall give as an inheritance from among our slaves, the one who was a taqi. Meaning, if you don't have to, إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مَفَازًا. Every time Allah promised Jannah, it's for the muttaqeen, muttaqeen, muttaqeen. If a muttaqi fell into a major sin, he became disqualified, maybe none of us will make it. Mind you, major sins are not restricted to zina and drinking alcohol. They could be backbiting a Muslim. It could be doing something, slandering someone. It could be, you know, many different things which people don't consider to be major sins, but are major sins. Go back to the book of Imam al-Dhahabi and learn about the kaba'ir. According to Ibn Abbas, they said they're closer to 700. Not seven, 700, the major sins. We may be committing them every day. But if we turn to Allah, then Allah Azza wa Jalla loves the muttaqeen. So, إن الله يحب التوابين ويحب المتطهرين. إن الله يحب المتقين وأحسنوا إن الله يحب المحسنين. أحسنوا is greater than do good. Good, جيد. إحسان is excellence. In other words, do work in an excellent manner. Excel, verily Allah loves those who excel. Ihsan can never be defined by anyone better than the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, who said, أَن تَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاهُ. It's to worship Allah as if you can see Him. That is the highest level of ibadah. Meaning you do it while looking forward to it, enjoying it, finding delight in it. You don't want it to stop. Look, akhi, when you're standing in salah and taraweeh, you're one of two people. You're one of two people. Someone who can't wait for the imam to finish, and someone who begs Allah that the imam doesn't finish. Which one are you? Do you just want to get out to have your sandwich and your food? Do you favor the dunya over the life to come? Do you want to run away from standing before Allah in salah so you can have fun with your friends outside? No.